हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द चैप्टर नंबर 2 फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ 11th एंड 12th क्लास इन द पोएम्स बुक एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज ब्रिजेस। दिस इज द चैप्टर नंबर 2 इन पोएम्स बुक। ब्रिज इज अ काइंड ऑफ ट्री विच इज वेरी थिन, मतलब ये एक ट्री है ब्रिज और जो कि काफ़ी पतला होता है। और इस पोएम में पोइट ने स्टार्टिंग लाइन्स में इमेजिनेशन और रियलिटी थीम को डिस्क्राइब करते हुए बताया है। और पोइट इमेजिन करता है कि ये जो ट्री है किसी बॉय के द्वारा झुका दिया गया होगा, बट वो इसके बाद रियलिटी पर आता है कि ये आइस स्टॉर्म की वजह से ट्री झुका होगा, क्योंकि बॉय इस ट्री को इस तरीके से नहीं झुका सकता। इसके बाद पोइट अनदर थीम को एक्सप्लेन करते हुए कहता है, जो कि थीम है द नीड फॉर लिमिट्स, कि ह्यूमन बींग को अपनी लिमिट में रहना चाहिए। जिस तरीके से ट्री ऊंचाई तक जाता है बट डज नॉट लीव इट्स ग्राउंड, लेकिन अपने ओरिजिन प्लेस को नहीं छोड़ता है, उसी तरीके से ह्यूमन बींग को डाउन टू अर्थ रहना चाहिए। ये एक मैसेज भी है जो पोएट यहाँ पर इस पोएम के थ्रू देना चाहता है। नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट द पोएम। दिस इज द पोएम बाय रॉबर्ट फ्रॉस्ट एंड व्हेन आई सी ब्रिजेस बेंड टू लेफ्ट एंड राइट अक्रॉस द लाइंस ऑफ स्ट्रेट डार्कर ट्रीज, मीन्स व्हेन एवर पोएट सीज द ब्रिजेस बेंडिंग लेफ्ट एंड राइट across the straight darker trees, he thinks some boy is being swinging them, means any of the boy is swinging them, but swinging does not bend them down to stay as ice storm do, but because of the swinging the tree cannot bend down, as it may be because of the ice storm. Often you must have seen them loaded with ice a sunny winter morning after a rain. In the next line, poet is telling us that we have often seen the tree loaded with ice after a wintry sunny morning, or in the winter sunny morning after a rain. They click upon themselves as the breeze rises, means ice starts clicking themselves when the breeze rises. And turn many colored, and it turns into many color when the sunrise reaches over there. As the stir cracks and creases their enamel, and because of the movement, ice breaks into pieces, and the tree also does not remain for a longer time in its actual position. Soon the sun's warmth makes them shed crystal shells, shattering and avalanching on the snow crust. And because of the warmth of the sun, the ice breaks into pieces, and it looks like the ice is falling like an avalanche. Such heaps of broken glass to sweep away. And now in the next lines, poet is comparing the ice with the broken glass. यानी कि ब्रोकन ग्लास से आइस को कंपेयर किया जा रहा है कि जिस तरीके से आइस टूटने के बाद चारों तरफ बिखर जाती है, उसी तरीके से जस्ट लाइक अ ब्रोकन ग्लास। यू वुड थिंक द इनर डूम ऑफ हेवन हैड फॉलन, एंड इट लुक्स लाइक अ इनर डूम ऑफ हेवन हैड फॉलन। दे आर ड्रैग्ड टू द विदर्ड ब्रेकन बाय द लोड, मीन्स ट्री बेंड डाउन बिकॉज ऑफ द हैवी लोड, एंड दे सीम नॉट टू ब्रेक, and it cannot be said that the tree will broken down, though once they are bowed so low for long, but once the trees have bent down they never right themselves, the tree cannot stand straight, matlab jab ek bar tree jhuk gaya hai ice ki wajah se wo dobara se seedha nahi khada ho sakta. You may see their trunks arching in the woods, and we can see their trunks curved, arching का मतलब कर्व, यानी कि वो मुड़ चुकी है किसमें, वुड्स की तरफ। Year afters, afterwards trailing their leaves on the ground, and trailing means hanging, and after a long time their leaves are hanging on the ground like gulls on hands and knees that throw their hair. And now the poet is comparing the leaves with the gulls' hairs, like the gull on hands and knees that throw their hair. That means जिस तरीके से कोई गर्ल अपने बालों को लटका देती है before them over their heads to dry in the sun, कि मतलब अपने गीले बालों को सन में सुखाने के लिए, उसी तरीके से जो लीव्स हैं वो मतलब लटक जाती हैं। because of the heavy load. But I was going to say when truth broken, but in reality, poet was not trying to tell the reality, how the tree bent down, लेकिन suddenly उसके मुंह से truth बाहर आ जाता है, यानी कि poet सच बताना नहीं चाह रहा था कि किस तरीके से ये tree actual में झुका, but suddenly the truth broken, with all her matter of fact about the ice storm. I should prefer to have some boy bend them. Even then, now poet starts imagining and says that any of the boy has bent down the tree. Now poet starts imagining after knowing the reality also कि किसी boy ने ही इसे झुकाया होगा. As he went out and in to fetch the cows, at that time the boy has gone to fetch the cows. Some boys too far from town to learn baseball. There are some boys who do not know to play the games like baseball, where or whose only play was what he found himself, and they love to play the games what they found themselves, summer or winter, and could play alone. In every season they love to play alone, means they are talking about the children who do not know to play many games in the village, summer or winter, and could play alone, and they mostly spend their time by playing alone. Now in the next line, मतलब next line में poet अब क्या बताना चाह रहा है कि किस तरीके से उस boy ने उस tree पर चढ़ने में success हासिल की, how he conquered. This theme is being described here. One by one he subdued his father's tree. Subdued means he started controlling all the trees of his father's village by riding them down over and over again. He started riding them over and over again until he took the stiffness. Stiffness ka matlab uski kathorta. Until he took the stiffness out of them, he continued riding over them, and not one but hung limp, not one was left for him to conquer. And when the stiffness was not left, nothing was left to conquer. Conquer ka matlab jeetna. Jab usne us tree ki stiffness ko le liya, to ab uske liye jeet hasil karna bahut aasan ho gaya tha. He learned all there was to learn about launching out too soon. Now he had learned how to prevent the tree from bending out too soon. मतलब उस बच्चे ने सीख लिया था कि किस तरीके से ट्री को झुकने से पहले ही उस ट्री के टॉप पर पहुंचना है. In the next lines, and so not carrying the tree away clear to the ground, and he had learned how to prevent the tree from reaching to the ground before reaching on the top. और इसके लिए वो क्या करता था, he always kept his poise to the top branches. Poise means he started balancing on the top branches, climbing carefully with the same pains you used to fill a cup up to the brim. The pain we experience while filling a cup with the tea or water, the same pain he started experiencing or started taking every step carefully and even above the brim. Then he flung outward feet first with a swish, kicking his way down through the air to the ground. And after that, when he reached on the top, he suddenly started running towards the ground. So was I once myself a swinger of birches. So isse upar line mein kya bataya gaya tha ki now like this the boy learned how to climb over the tree without bending it down too soon. So was I once myself a swinger of birches. Now the poet is trying to tell us ki he was also a swinger of birches, yani ki wo bhi birch tree par jhulta tha. And so I dream of going back to be, and he is dreaming to go back to his childhood. It's when I was weary of considerations, and whenever he's tired, he starts thinking about it. And life is too much like a pathless wood, and he's disappointed at this time and comparing the life with a pathless wood. Pathless wood means there is no clear path. Where your face burns and tickle with cobwebs, that means where you have to burn your face to live comfortably, and tickles with the cobwebs broken across it. And cobwebs also attack so many times, and one eye is weeping from a twig's having lashed across it open. And if a twig of a tree pierces in your eyes, your one of the eye is starts weeping. One eye is weeping is referring here to the inner sorrow. That means so many times we suffer from the inner sorrow. Yani ki kai baar hame life mein different types ke sorrow ko face karna padta hai. I would like to get away from earth a while means for a short while. I want to remain away from the earth and then come back to it and begin over, and wants to come back to the earth again. That means what is poet trying to tell us? Ki he wants to remain away from the earth for a short while and wants to reach on the top, but wants to come back to the earth. May no fate willfully misunderstand me and half grant what I wish. Means wo kya keh raha hai? Ki his fate should not misunderstand him and give him half whatever he want and snatch me away not to return. That means he wants to reach on the top and wants to return also. Earth the right place for love, because earth is the right place for love. And he's trying to refer ki we must be down to earth even after reaching on the top. Yani kisi high position ko hasil karne ke baad bhi hame down to earth rehna chahiye. I don't know where it's likely to go better. The poet does not know which other place is maybe better. I would like to go by climbing a birch tree. Matlab wo birch tree par climb karna pasand karta hai, and climb back branches up a snow white trunk towards heaven, and wants to reach towards heaven till the tree could bear no more, up to the time or as much as he can go high, but dipped its top and sat me down again. But he wants to come back to the earth. That would be good, both going and coming back, and nothing can be better than this, to reach on the top and come back to the earth. One could do worse than be a swinger of birches. Last line mein poet kya keh raha hai ki isse bada kuch nahi ho sakta ki agar koi bhi person अपनी लाइफ में कोई अटेम्प्ट ही नहीं लेता है. दैट मीन्स नथिंग कैन बी वर्स देन दिस इफ अ पर्सन डज नॉट टेक एनी अटेम्प्ट टू गो अहेड इन हिज लाइफ. सो लाइक दिस द पोएट इज गिविंग अ मैसेज थ्रू दिस पोयम दैट वी शुड लिव इन आवर लिमिट्स एंड वी मस्ट बी डाउन टू अर्थ. सो स्टूडेंट्स, इफ यू लाइक दिस वीडियो यू कैन लाइक एंड सब्सक्राइब दिस चैनल and press the bell icon for the latest videos.